true freedom is found in not having this inclination and desire to turn against our Creator. That's the true freedom. After I prayed, I felt like I had been fighting. Not figuratively fighting, I mean physically brawling my entire life, and that I finally had a chance to sit down and rest. That rest never went away. As C.S. Lewis put it, I believe in Christianity as I believe that the sun has risen, not only because I see it, but because by it, I see everything else.
It was near. My life had meaning now, because now I could go out and preach the word. I didn't have to just sit back and say, hey, everyone who does good deeds will get to heaven. No, now there was meaning. Now there was, people need to know who God is, what He has done. People need to know what our position is in relation to Him. They need to know that we have to worship the one true God and His Son, Jesus Christ, who came to die for our sins. We have to tell people that yes, God is one. However, He's one in three and three in one. Whether we can understand that or not is beyond our scope. We don't have to understand it. All we have to do is understand that Christ is God, that God decided to come down as a person.
And every day from that day forward, I truly felt the desires for those things to fall away. And now I stand and wonder, almost 2 years later, a year and a half later, thinking, wow, God is so good. Here I was, I didn't believe Him. I just leaped out in faith, and yet He did what He said He would do. He would take those desires away. He would make me a new creature, just like it says in His Word. He's given me a new heart with new desires. And I thank Him, and I rejoice in what He has done for me. And I marveled at His goodness and His mercy to me and His long suffering.
With both my sisters that night. And come to find out later on, they weren't actually saved that day. There's a difference in making a profession of faith and actually meaning it, and then making a profession of faith and actually getting saved. The difference is the repentance and changing your heart and giving your life to Christ. That's the whole difference. You can pray a prayer and say, Lord, please save me, and not mean it and think you're going to heaven. That's not going to get you into heaven. A prayer is not what's going to get you into heaven if you don't mean it. So you have to mean it. And come to find out, they didn't really mean it, but I did that night. Our preacher was talking to us, or talking to my dad about baptism and stuff, and I'm not sure why, but my dad asked my other sisters if they wanted to do it, and they said no. He never came to me to ask me, and I don't know why that happened, but so they decided no, they didn't want to get baptized, and so I was like, what? Like, why? And I just couldn't understand, why would you not want to get baptized after you just got saved? So I got baptized that October. And what baptism is really is, that's not what gets you into heaven, is the actual being saved and, you know, just giving your life to Christ. That's what gets you to heaven. But baptism is just showing the church that this is my new life, this is the next step that I'm taking, and just showing everybody that you're a Christian now, and the Bible says you should be baptized after you're saved. So you know, it's what God would want you to do.
And my mum come that same day, and I told her what had happened. And she was trying to explain it all away, you know. It's like, oh, well, you just poured out your heart, you know. You feel better, really. You know, you've had a good cry, and, you know, everybody feels better, you know. I was like, oh, no. going, and I went to give her a hug. But this feeling I got as I went to give her a hug, it was like a weight. When I went to give her a hug, it was a weight, and it was a law telling me, you know, your mum doesn't know me. Your mum doesn't know me, and you know where she's going now. And it was like a grief, and then, so, you know, and I just wish that weight sometimes would come back, you know, for the loss, because I feel like I do the Lord a disfavour, because I feel like I don't do enough, you know.
I witnessed to everybody I met, not in a fanatical, wide-eyed way, but when I met people, I'd carry tracts everywhere. I got in a box and began preaching in a local city. If anyone could have been considered a fanatic in those days, it was me.
One sign you are saved is that Jesus will be your Lord. And when he says, go into all the world, preach the gospel to every creature, you'll do what your Lord commands you to do.
You know, I've found everlasting life. I cannot but speak that which I've seen and heard.
Proud to have my story on that piece of paper. And I got laughed at, and I got called Jesus freak and Jesus boy and, you know, all kind of stuff. But I was changed.
Before long, he learned he could blend his passion for God and his ability as a rapper.
I thought that God and rap would never work. I thought that God wasn't okay with rap. You know, people knew I used to rap, and I went to the Bible studies, and someone said, hey, why don't you, you know, rap about Jesus? And so I just on the spot, I just came up with the rap about Jesus, and they were like, man, that was good. And I was like, wow, Lord, maybe you could really do something with this.
He began ministering to kids in juvenile detention.
I ended up there for 3 years, every weekend, just sharing my heart and sharing scripture and rapping as their praise and worship on Sundays.
His music has spread around the world. His newest CD, Rebel, debuted at number 2 on iTunes. But his purpose goes way beyond selling CDs.
I want to use my art form to encourage the movement in the church to say, hey, let's engage the city, let's rebuild the city. And so that's really where my heart is to rebuild cities, is to see the city come to Jesus. And if you don't know him, you're missing out on purpose, meaning, and life in general. And so I'm passionate about seeing people spend eternity with him. He's awesome.
The love of a father that he missed as a child, he now finds in his relationship with God.
He's just loved on me when I felt like I didn't deserve love, when I felt like I was unlovable. I'm really grateful, and I feel fortunate to have a huge family that is beyond race, creed, culture, and to have a father who shepherds us all. And when I think about that, my mind's blown. I mean, there's nothing like it.